I am Dr. Vishwanath, consultant nephrologist and HOD in nephrology. I am working at Manipal Hospital, Bangalore. Chronic kidney disease means permanent kidney damage or an irreversible kidney damage, which may happen over a period of time. As we all know, kidneys help in filtering blood. Kidneys not only help in filtering blood, they also help in regulating blood pressure, regulating hemoglobin, regulating the bone. Whenever there is onset of chronic kidney disease, there will be impairment of all these things. One is kidney function will come down, cleaning of the blood will come down, basically filtering of the blood will come down. And obviously, because kidney also regulates hemoglobin, hemoglobin will start coming down. Essentially, with all these things, there will be an irreversible kidney damage, which will lead to a perpetual damage to the kidney and further progression of kidney damage and also worsening of blood pressure, worsening of anemia, worsening of bone disease. The most common causes of kidney disease all over the world is diabetes and hypertension. In our country also, because diabetics are going to be on rise, and in fact India is being called as capital of diabetes, diabetic kidney disease is the number one cause for kidney disease. Apart from this, uncontrolled hypertension is the second cause. Many a times people will see that blood pressure is a little higher, they'll think they may manage with low salt, diet, exercise, but still, unless you monitor and make sure blood pressure is under control, it will definitely go and damage kidney. These are two important causes. Apart from these, in our country, many times people will go to the pharmacy, take over-the-counter medications which may harm the kidney, long-term usage of painkillers without prescription, without guidance, sometimes native drugs without knowing what it contains can cause damage. Apart from these three important causes, the most other common causes are recurrent infections of the kidney which are ignored, presence of protein in the urine which is not taken care of appropriately, sometimes rarely congenital problems, or some if people are born with defects in the kidney can lead to kidney dysfunction. Unfortunately, kidney disease most often doesn't have any symptoms unless there is a significant decline in kidney function. Initially, there may be some vague symptoms like unexplained anemia, feeling weak, tiredness, which is often attributed to anemia. Many a times, anytime you find unexplained anemia, you have to go to the bottom and see if kidney is contributing or not. You have to make sure that kidney functions are okay. Then only you will know whether kidney is contributing or not. Apart from these, when the kidney functions decline beyond 90% kidney is damaged, then only you develop symptoms like swelling of the feet, swelling of the face, recurrent vomiting, nausea. Sometimes you can have unexplained weight loss because you don't feel like eating, you don't feel all that good, you always feel like resting, sleeping. So these are all vague symptoms. There is no specific symptom to tell this can come with kidney, unlike heart where you have some chest pain, you go to your doctor, see and get evaluated. Most often, by the time you develop symptoms and go to your doctor, there may be a significant kidney damage. That's the reason, don't wait for the symptoms to come in to check for kidney. You need to check for the kidney even before the symptoms arrive, because by the time symptoms set in and you start detecting kidney problem, it may be a very late stage. Treatment of chronic kidney disease depends on various stages. Stage 1, 2 and 3 are early stages where basically there will be no medication specific for kidney disease. You need to control the underlying cause. Like if you have diabetes, control diabetes well, keep the sugars under control. If you have blood pressure, control the blood pressure well. Suppose somebody is smoking, quit smoking. Smoking is something which is highly toxic, not only involves heart, it involves kidney, eyes, all the organs, lungs, definitely it's going to affect. So if somebody is smoking, quitting smoking is very important. And as I said earlier, avoiding things which are harmful to the kidney, like painkillers. If you have any infection, urinary infection, kidney infection, treat it appropriately. These are the things most important in the early stage. In stage 4, where there is a significant dysfunction, where almost 60%, 70% of the kidney is damaged, here you should be more important in controlling the blood pressure, controlling things which are harmful to the kidney. Make sure you reduce the protein in the urine. There are some specific medications which we can use to protect kidney, like what we call as ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers, which are proven to help preventing further progression. Beyond this, when somebody reaches stage 5 or when there is kidney damage more than 85-90%, beyond that we cannot maintain with medications. Once they reach stage 5, the only option is to go for either dialysis or, if they are fit enough, to go for a kidney transplant. Prevention of chronic kidney disease is the most important thing. Prevention is something which we can definitely do in kidney disease, because once the kidney disease damage starts, we cannot do much to prevent further progression. So we need to prevent chronic kidney disease in the form of controlling blood pressure, controlling blood sugar, quitting smoking, avoiding things which are harmful to the kidney like painkillers, over-the-counter medications. Monitor kidney functions so that you see how the kidney functions are and see if we can make it better. If there is any active infection, treat it appropriately and on the right time. Don't ignore any symptoms like swelling of the feet, having unexplained anemia, unexplained weight loss. Look for kidney disease and see if we can treat it appropriately. Prevention definitely goes a very long way in kidney disease. As the old saying goes, an ounce of prevention is better than a pound of treatment. So definitely a kidney disease, an ounce of prevention is better than a ton of treatment.